Thank you. the votes. Next we'll have Perryville and Bismarck, whenever that game is start. The blue mills to my left burn. They just started playing, and they currently lead Evans to the left. Valley currently leads Indians 19-15. Hirschman to serve. Over there you had the Burning Mules and the Advance red and black team. Great serve by Myers. Move on to play the winner of the Advance Bloomfield game, but the Arcade Valley Bloomfield game. You would see right here, but we will not have that for you. St. Vincent down by four. The last time they were down by four, they were able to take a win over Saxon, Lutheran, and Two Cities. Good hit by Vaughn. And the Indians got it within three. That's number one. finale is going to call match point here in the first match. Tigers.
Thank you.
Hinton 8, Valley 14. Thank you. being weak for the serve.
dime. This is a nickel. It equals 15 cents.
Thank you.
Cody over there? Cody. You sure, right? Oh, me and him were going to go out there after the tournament's all done. I tried, he didn't answer it two times. Okay. Well, see you later. Thank you. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are just set for the Valley Catholic Arcadia Valley game. I will not be doing the play-by-play because I'm looking forward to doing the play-by-play for the championship game. Here's the information we're going to predict who's going to win. You look here. Valley defeats St. Vincent in 2-3 sets. So you have Valley Catholic a win away, 253 much points from even meeting Perryville Bismarck or Epic in the tournament. Right here, this court that you're looking at here on BBTV 95 will be the home for the championship game roughly 2 hours from now. We hope you enjoy the volleyball games now as I send it down low for Arcadia Valley versus Valley Catholic. The next game we will play, if time constrains us due to having enough information, will be hopefully PHS and Bismarck. We'll show you some highlights of the Valley Catholic football for our team. There they go. Thank you.
all the way down there. Back row on the end. Back row on the end in the black. On the back row. In the back row.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the championship game here on PVTV 985. I'm Landon King for PVTV 985 Digital Media, also on Facebook, PVTV Digital Media, PVTV 985, excuse me, on YouTube at PVTV CH 985, channel 985, Digital Media. Well, it's been a great game to bring you the championship game, and hey, you know, when you look at the bracket in the pool play, the team that is playing for the championship only lost one match. That is impossible to do. But it's not impossible when you're 29th in the state like the hope-to-be champions there in blue and white from St. Genevieve, Missouri, Valley Catholic Warriors. Now, you remember earlier today during the Bloomfield Valley Catholic game. I don't know if this might be a mistake to do this because Valley lost to Bloomfield, tied up 1-1. But you know how I told you I was going to keep you up to date. Well, I decided not to do announcing earlier because I didn't know any other team really that well. So, anyways, Valley lost a football game. It is true, they lost to Lamar Tigers 50-14. So the 54 straight home games are 54 straight winning games are lost. And first kill tonight goes to the blue and white. Let them fight, Valley Catholic Warriors, who are hoping to show off their 30 people, 15 to 25 fans. A delicious championship as Valley takes the lead 10-0 over to Advance Hornets. Earlier you heard me say Advance Tigers, but thanks to Keith Winkler, wherever you are, you bad boy, you said it was the Tigers. So it's the Air Hornets taking on the Mighty Warriors. I was talking to a few people with Valley earlier and say, hey, why don't you guys do this for the football team? You know, redemption for the football team losing. I think that would be great. We want to thank everybody from coming from Advance, about 45, 50 miles south. Bosler hits it into the nosebleed section. Just kidding. So Valley's the home team in a way. You would almost think as they're still Mighty and they're still the Warriors. Remember, after the game, after tonight's game is over, no matter how long we play, we will have the trophy presentation by David Marley, the Perryville head coach of the Perryville Pirates. He will give a second place award to the second place team, let their fans applaud. And then the winning team will get handed their trophy. We'll try to get zoom in shots of those beautiful trophies. Plaques made. I believe Advance has like six. Valley six. Yes, now seven. The Advance is one. Hey, Scott, why are you shaking your head about? He's like, no, that's not right. Bosler with the hit, kill. The Barrow, she's ready, like, hey, last year Perryville got second place. This year, they're not getting second place near St. Vincent. We're going to take it all. And now it's time that I can give you my prediction from Thursday evening. I'm looking at the tournament bracket with my grandfather. And I'm like, Grandpa, I don't want to tell anybody this, but I'm predicting, in a way, Valley Catholic to go all the way. First game, win-win. Second game, win-win. Third game, loss, win. Fourth game, win-win, all the way up to now. We'll be right back. Sorry, the microphone wanted to get in the way of the information. Advance after the timeout. Man, it's getting in. It's after 7, I think. Yeah, 7:45. That's fine. Hey, don't forget, Wednesday is the St. Vincent Perryville volleyball game we'll have right here on TV 985. We started this tournament at 8:30 this morning. 11 hours into it, and Valley Catholic is still playing. Man, these ladies have to be tired. I mean, you know, you only got two sophomores and, you know, two freshmen to everybody. The rest of them are juniors and seniors with, two seniors and Allie Weiler, number 14, and Hannah Barr, number 8. Correction. Abby Umfleet, number 5, is also a senior. For juniors, you have the libero, two when she's not liberoing, number 42 when she is. The awesome Sydney Spears. Excuse me, Sydney Bosler. You also have Riley Wilk. You also have number 11, Hannah Viox, and number 13, Taylor Seibel, and number 19, Molly Fisher. And number 20, libero. Number 41, libero, Peggy Hyde. Coach is Nancy Fisher, and assisting her is Coach Don Bosler. Sydney's ball. Warriors 12. Let's try and get Harnett in here. Harnett's 5. Valley now 13-5. Well on their way to a state champion, to a volleyball championship. 29th in the class. 29th in the state. Number 1 in class. 1. Other teams in their class would be the Advanced Hornets. Also would be the St. Vincent Indians along with Bismarck Indians. Oh, my goodness. Those who have been here are like, we're tired of the refs not giving us those points. Those kills, okay. But the refs are doing a good job. You know, you gotta be, you know, 11 and a half hours. It should be 11 and a half hours before this game is over. I'd say over 1,000 people at the whole entire location today. Want to thank, of course, Valley Catholic Warriors for coming down here from St. Jen on Highway 61 and 55, whichever road you may take. And I know you made a long drive down here at 8 a.m. and, you know, Advance didn't warm up, according to Mr. Bosler over here to my right. We're the only two up here on the concourse. Under track. Hey, Emily, if you're here, you're needed at operations, they just announced. Emily Skill, that is. The one that lets you have fun, you know, takes you to the Cardinal games, the Blues games. Hey, guys, we're going to do 2 Cardinal trips this year, so, hey. I know they won the last 3 times we went with the Parks there. Let's keep it up. Really? Hey, one fake athletic director, Jeff Steffens. Coming out here today, all day, sacrificed his day enjoying volleyball. Thank you, Coach Steffens, for making the trip over. I want to also thank all the fans who have ran after the volleyball today during the games and players running off. All of them, the line judges with the flags out here, as you see a guy in Southeast Missouri in internet newspaper with the red flag. He'll put the he'll make the official back it up. We might try to get you two fast kids. Now we got another member up here on the track looking for Emily. Tell you what, if Valley stays on this roll that they are on right now, when they get to the final, sorry, okay, final, sorry. I actually forgot. It's been 11 and a half hours that we've been here. So. Dave Murley's like, you know, I'm a little tired, but I'm not tired at all to give away the trophies. I love giving them. I got two very special ones for, you know, first place team and second place team. We're going to take a timeout here on PVTV 95, and the team will actually take one, as we'll take one with them. No commercials in this game here. Just a bunch of wires making havoc. Oh, by the way, see, I forgot. Valley's sophomores are number 25, Grace Elfrink. Number 10, Lanny Ballman. Those are your two sophomores. Your freshmen are Rachel Lorda and Olivia Meyer. Not for sure who the athletic director is at Valley, but for the, on the boys' side, it's well, the man that studies anything about football, Judd Nager. Speaking of football, I'm sure Valley could have used Connor Bosler today. Connor going to be playing baseball at SEMO, so look out, whoever SEMO's going to face. You might need a catcher like Molina if you want to throw anybody out. Bosler can bunt, hit a run, pitch. Can't strike out. He doesn't know how to strike out. He is why Valley Catholic won three straight baseball championships and three four-string football championships. Within 54 wins, by the way, too. Cindy has served. Oh, advance with the point. Back out of 20, it looks like 19. Hey, official, I can't see the number. 21, I think it is. I'm barely 19, but I think maybe 15. We'll see here what they put up. Okay, it was 19. Do you guys want to play 3 matches, guys? Really? Valley up by 2, 22, 20. See, she saw things like, oh, I gotta get some scores while Linden's not down here. No, I'm gonna just wait for the Broncos. Well, I think the Barry Barks are for letting everybody enjoy their gym for 11 and a half hours. It will be 11 and a half hours. By the way, car crew is starting pretty soon. 63 degrees out here in Perryville area. Take a good breach on that one. All right, so I just asked one of our fans up here. Any clown reports yet, St. Jen? No. That's good, because there was one in Chester. One in Bloomsdale. I haven't seen Bozo up here yet on his unicycle. I haven't seen anybody try to juggle a volleyball, so that far we don't have no clowns out here playing. Get ready for the next match. points in the first match. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, got one final in a bracket. Have Murfreesboro taking the win over Cape Central in the fifth place game. Fifth place goes to Murfreesboro Red Devils. Junior varsity team, congratulations, Murfreesboro. I'm wondering if any of the other teams would come over here. To display their beautiful trophies. Jeff Stevens will be on his way here to deliver some beautiful hardware to two awesome teams. Several people have stuck around here. So the question is, who has the strength? Who's tireder but wants to put this into consideration? As we will at least play 11 and a half hours. Just about. We're 15 minutes away from making it 11 and a half hours. I want to thank everybody for coming out tonight for all the games this evening. I know a lot of college football, but hey, you are enjoying a good volleyball game here. At least I hope that you are, depending on who you're rooting for. This is match number 2. We can play 3 if necessary. So, folks, talking to somebody up here. In baseball, if the Cardinals win tomorrow, we will all be Dodger fans once again. Right now, Adam Wainwright, if you're listening tonight, we all love you, and we want to see you have a great game and win 10-0 because I'm watching Valley number 10 serve the ball. We would like you anyways to win and maybe get a home run and leave it up to the Dodgers to decide if they can come back and pull off a whipping upset to help the Cardinals. Mets have officially clinched a playoffs berth. Valley Catholic is currently in a losing playoff berth. Correction. I'm watching the scoreboard and I'm calling it like a baseball game. Whoa, what a good hit for 14 and for Advance. Oh, one-handed hit by number 4 to the libero. For Valley Catholic. Bosler. We'll see here next year on September 30th. Less than a year, guys. 364 days till we see Valley, St. Vincent, Perryville, Saxony, North County, Fredericktown, Advance, hopefully. Time out. And there goes the ball. It's deep, and it's gone. A home run by Basel. Just kidding. Jeff Steffens, please report downstairs. You are late. Where are you? You better start getting here with your trophy. I want to see that thing. Yes, I do. Valley now. 7? Let's see here. 10-10, tied up ball game. It was Kay Hyde. Tied up again, 11-11. Touchdown, Warriors! Well, it's 12, so it's a two touchdowns. Or that was the score from earlier today. I wonder if Advance is like, hey, we want to get 50. I wouldn't think you could, but it's making the fans get their energy exercise here at Perryville. Perryville, whatever you call it, Perryville Parks here. Okay, good idea. We'll call it that. We'll have Mayor's Cup, by the way, in January. I'll be here if I'm not still here from this tournament. Yeah, we'll spend the rest of the year here, I'm sure, as long as this stays going. We're only about 8 minutes away from making this a 11 and a half hour event. So. Get ready to get loud, folks. That's all I can say. We only got 65 minutes to hang out with you guys, so let's make the rest of the 65 minutes a memorial time. I was like, hey, we're only 10 points away. Magic number is down to 9 for Valley Catholic to clinch the championship. It might be down to 8 because there's the lethal Zosler. Great at everything. Four, you can put 40 points up in basketball against St. Vincent, I must add. Lucky number down to 8. Hey, Magic number is down to 8. Magic number is for Advance to take a tie is 9. Should be if the scoreboard operator decides to. Okay, they're not going to do it. All right, that's good. We'll take it. Well, you'll take it. Magic number is 7. When the magic number gets down to 2, I will let you enjoy hearing the crowd. And I will say so long from Perry Park Center, but hey, not really, because we still have championship in so long from hearing me talk, but you can still see some of the volleyball game. Valley Catholic, oh my goodness. magic number at the number of a touchdown. Magic number now is Riley Wook's number. Looking for Abby Unfleet's number to click. Oh, but watch out. Okay. The ball cleared the other net. Oh, my. Wow, this is a good game. Magic number now at 5 for Valley. Timeout. Take 1-2. Correction on the headphones on me. All right, talking with people. Number 41 is Kylie. Kyle. Like Ohio. So you got something like that, and then you have Perryville's coach Ames, like Ames, Iowa. So you got states, okay. Magic number, magic number is at Lloyd's. Rachel Lloyd, number 4. Jeff Steffens, please get your butt over here right now. If you're not here, we will be waiting for you. Magic number whenever they fix the scoreboard. It's still at 4. Turn to the scoreboard. Okay. Oh my goodness. We might have a match 3. Jeff Stevens, I know you're watching, buddy. If Advance scores 5 points here before Valley can score 4, you can still watch that game over there at the high school. But I don't see that happen. Just kidding. Advance. We have a tie. 21-21. We have a match number 3. David. Coach Marley's like, man, I'm enjoying this away from my family and kids. Advance takes the lead. Timeout, Warriors. We'll take 1-2. I've liked her goodbye way for Valley is Patricia. Magic number, ladies and gentlemen, at 4, ladies and gentlemen. Magic number is 3, Olivia Meyer. Can they get the Bosler's number when she won't be the libero? Who's gonna win? Hannah Barber. Hey, oh my goodness. Okay, it's time for me to sign off because we are at magic number 3. Thanks for watching PVTV Sports coverage of championship game. I'll be in that back to introduce the winner. 1 point away for Valley. Oh my goodness, here we go. Magic number one, they have now clinched a shot. They are your 2016 Perryville Volleyball Tournament champions. Now we're going to be awaiting the hardware. Don't go nowhere. Stay right here as we're going to get Jeff Stephens out here to Dave Murley. Dave Murley actually has got little things for him. He's giving out my ribbons. We're going to let you do the inductions here. After they give the trophy, you are free to go, and so are you, so am I. Thank you. I've liked her goodbye way for Valley's Patricia. Magic number, ladies and gentlemen, at four, ladies and gentlemen. Magic number is three, Olivia Meyer. Can they get to Bosler's number when she won't be the libero? Who's gonna win? Hannah Barber. Hey, oh my goodness. Okay, it's time for me to sign off because we are at magic number three. Thanks for watching PVTV Sports coverage of championship game. I'll be back to introduce the winner. One point away for Valley. Oh my goodness, here we go. Magic number one, they have now clinched a shot. They are your 2016 Perryville Volleyball Tournament champions. Now we're going to be awaiting the hardware. Don't go nowhere. Stay right here as we're going to get Jeff Steffens out here to Dave Marley. Dave Marley actually has got little things for him. She's giving out my ribbons. We're going to let you do the induction too. After they give the trophy, you are free to go, and so am I.